Hey everybody, it's Invicta. I want to make a very quick video outlining the upcoming balance update that we're going to be seeing for the 12th of October, which is in a couple days from now. As always, with these newsy type videos, you can find all the links down below to the official posts from Blizzard themselves. And of course, I encourage you to pause the video and read them at your leisure. I'm not going to be going over them word for word, but I am going to be covering the bigger bullet points and summary of this upcoming patch. Now, basically, this is a little bit of a mini patch. It's just a balance update. It does not cover anything that is currently on the PTR right now, which I have not done a video yet because, again, given the nature of the PTR, things do tend to change, and I just, unless there's like a major change like we saw a couple of weeks ago, I tend to not really address anything on the PTR. But this patch is very interesting because we see a lot of changes, including a Zarya nerf, as you saw here in the thumbnail. Now, I don't want to go too misleading with that, but it's just a little bit... It is a little bit of a nerf to Zarya in particular, but it's a little bit of a backpedal sort of deal instead of them just directly nerfing her. And that is in response to them overtuning the buffs that we had with Zarya a couple of weeks ago. And yeah, again, as a quick reminder, just check out the links down below. You can read it for yourself. All right, here we go. Upcoming Heroes of the Storm balance update for the 12th of October. They are going to be reducing the inner damage bonus from the nuclear missiles that you get on Warhead Junction by 50%. Basically, what they're trying to do is Blizzard's trying to limit those core rushes that you've been seeing on streams, and you probably have been living through them as well in solo queue and in quick matches as well. Blizzard said, and on top of that, the time at which the nuke upgrade, their damage has changed from 14 to 18 minutes. That basically is in direct response to the 14-minute hard pushes that we've been seeing on the Warhead Junction. Blizzard says this is a temporary solution to prevent the new core rushes at the 14-minute mark. In an upcoming patch, we will be likely making future changes that makes nukes gradually scale over time, so they will mirror the core scaling health over time. Now, something I will mention really quickly about Warhead Junction is that I do think that this change was definitely needed, but this is not something that I can really see them being able to correct, if I might use finger air quotation marks there for a second, just because of the nature of the actual design of the map. I like Warhead Junction. I like how it feels, but I think that it's going to be a little bit more tricky, and basically what I'm trying to say is don't expect the overhaul as far as like what Blizzard is alluding to here, making the scaling change, to happen anytime soon. I think that one's probably going to be a little bit more of a time sink for them to develop. However, I of course have all my utmost faith and trust in Blizzard and getting these sort of things taken care of and hashed out. Now, going over to the bigger portion of this video talking about the upcoming balance patches and the changes here for a couple of heroes, Vala getting a little bit of help, just a little bit. She's getting a little bit of help for her Caltrops as well as a damage increase. Her base damage increase for the Reign of Vengeance heroic that she has. I'm actually surprised they didn't do anything to Strafe. Strafe is very, very strong right now, and honestly, I think that it's a... I'm not going to say too strong. It's just very powerful, let's put it this way. So my sneaky suspicion is that this was done as far as the Reign of Vengeance buff in direct response to how strong and how widely picked we are seeing Strafe here as far as like the solo assassin builds that you see coming out from Vala. So the damage has been increased. The Caltrops, the slow amount has been increased by 5%. Not that big of a deal, but they've also increased the damage of the Caltrops damage by a whole lot, from 45 to 60. It's still not going to really do too much damage. Like, it's not going to be like a burst damage sort of thing, but it is very interesting that they're going to put a little bit more emphasis on Vala's crowd control ability, the Caltrop talent, rather than doing something else like if you're slow or with the multi-shot, etc., etc. So death dealer damage per hatred stack has increased from 12 to 14%. That is also a pretty nice little buff there for those of you who do take that level 7 talent. And then frost shock, the slow duration has been reduced from 2 seconds to 1.5 seconds. So Vala players, rejoice. You've got some pretty interesting changes coming up, and honestly, as a Vala player, I'm kind of happy about that. Going over to Nazebo did get a couple of nerfs here, but he also got a little bit of help in the non-gargantuan department. Gargantuan, the basic attack damage has been reduced from 195 to 176. The Ravenous Spirit, the damage of the other heroic that Nazebo has increased from 94 to a base of 103, and that is pretty darn nice. As someone who usually only takes Ravenous Spirit regardless of the lineup because I'm a giant noob, I love this because I think that the Ravenous Spirit at one point was probably way too strong earlier on in the beta testing and even going all the way back to technical alpha. So it's nice to see that they're going to be giving it a little bit of love after they did hit Ravenous Spirit pretty darn hard with the Nerf bat a while ago, and now it's going to be brought up to kind of level out the playing field as far as Gargantuan, who's now getting nerfed, versus the slightly lesser pick Ravenous Spirit talent. I think that's very cool indeed. Corpse Spiders reduces also, the cooldown's been reduced from 10 to 9 seconds. Not that big of a deal, but still, having it under 10 seconds is pretty nice for any Nazeebo player out there. I'm not going to go over any of the other talents here for Nazeebo, but I do want to cover really quickly what Blizzard mentions about him, because this is very interesting what they say. Blizzard says, right now, zombie wall talents are providing more utility and damage rather than the alternatives, which is not ideal. We're providing buffs to Corpse Spiders while also nerfing Gargantuan. In general, we expect Nazeebo's win rate to stay about the same, which is right in the middle, but increase the number of effective talent options for different playstyles. Now, something that they mentioned about the W ability, the Zombie Wall talents, especially going over to Dead Rush, for example, what some people were doing is they were basically using the zombies, the corpses that Nazeebo creates out of the ground when he does his Zombie Wall. They were basically using that more as a primary damage-dealing ability, which is not really supposed to be. But at the same time, like, I think it's interesting that Blizzard says, like, you know, Zombie Wall is giving too much damage and utility, but it's kind of like, I feel like the whole point of the zombie rush and the Zombie Wall in general was to deal damage, and then giving Nazeebo that huge burst of a necromancer type push whenever the zombies come charging up out of the ground after they've been resurrected by Nazeebo. I mean, like, that's what the talent has always been doing, so I thought it was very curious that they're talking about it, that it's providing a little bit too much damage and utility, so which is the reason why they're going to scale that back a little bit. I personally didn't think that they dealt that much damage, but I might be a little bit biased because I've been playing Nazeebo for a very long time. But it's still very neat that we do get the Ravenous Spirit change. I think that one's going to be proving a little bit bigger than maybe a couple people are estimating here from Blizzard's side. So, going on to Malfurion, again, another hero that I mainline as a support. The mana costs have been increased for regrowth, along with the cooldown increase for entangling roots. Now, basically, what Blizzard is going to be doing, oh yeah, by the way, one of the biggest ones, and I was super duper sad about this, was rampant growth has been completely removed, which is really sad for me as a Malfurion player, because I do primarily play Malfurion if I'm not playing Illidan, is like, Blizzard does not want Malfurion to be a burst healer. They want him to be a heal over time, or a hot healer. No pun intended there. And I really feel like the problem with Malfurion isn't necessarily his burst healing, but it's the amount of mana that he churns through early on. I feel like a change like this is fine as long as you give us back Conjurer's Will, or Conjurer's Pursuit, rather. That's what I really, really want from Malfurion, because I really miss that. That was so powerful, almost too powerful, but anyway, here's what Blizzard says about the Malfurion changes. Blizzard says, we are happy with how Malfurion has now played after his changes, but he has come out a little too strong. We believe that his role as a sustained healing support still should be a primary strength, but we want to limit how long he can keep up his team. He can keep his team going if he's just spamming the regrowth on cooldown, meaning that, of course, as soon as it's off cooldown, he's going to be hitting that Q over and over and over again, which, honestly, that's what everyone was doing at Malfurion anyway, which, again, is a little bit of a curious choice of words there. But we are also recutting rampant growth as it pushed Malfurion towards being a burst healer, which is against the role that he should be filling for his team. We also like that entangling roots allows Malfurion to make plays and initiate fights, but it's a little too good right now at securing kills. We're slightly decreasing its initial delay between where it is now and where it used to be, which should give opponents more of a chance to dodge the root. Honestly, I really don't think that a 0.05, like a 500th of a second change, is going to be that noticeable or big of a deal. Whether or not it's actually going to have any sort of bearing on the way that Entangling Roots lands now, I don't know. I severely doubt it, but some theory crafters out there may be like, hey, Zinvicta, 500ths of a second's pretty darn good, and I'll say, okay, well, I guess I was wrong then. But as a Malfurion player, I'm a little bummed out about Rampant Growth. That was one of the best talents that you could take from Malfurion, and really the only thing that could keep him as far as in line when competing up against, like, a Brightwing or an Uther, or even if you want to go for the Lieutenant Morales. But Blizzard knows what they're doing. They're going to try this out. If it's too bad, they'll try to revert it back or anything like that, but I still would be fine with all these changes, in particular to regrowth, except I just want Conjurer's Pursuit so bad. That was like the most, like, crushing change ever. And here's the storm for me, was losing the Conjurer's Pursuit talent at level 1 for Malfurion. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Crazy Uncle Chen getting a little bit of a nerf, surprisingly, considering that he's been, I don't want to say too weak out the gate for a while now, but it is very hilarious to see, and somewhat sad. I don't mean to laugh in the face of Chen players out there, and a little bit sad panda face, literally, that he is going to be getting a little bit of a nerf on his survivability. But let's be honest, trying to kill Chen one-on-one was nearly impossible. So they're going to be reducing the maximum base health of Chen's HP from 2658 to 2550, and they're also going to be decreasing the regen by probably a negligible amount. We'll wait and see, but it's still a nerf nonetheless. For his heroic Storm, Earth, and Fire, the base spirit health has been reduced by, again, not that much. It's going to be scaling up still just fine. I don't think that's really going to be that noticeable. However, we are going to see a little bit of a change here, in particular with the pressure point talent, and the baseline slow amount has been reduced from 40 to 35%. So basically about the, oh yeah, and by the way, the bonus slow amount has been reduced as well. The thing that's very interesting about the Chen change in particular was that Chen was very, very good at getting in people's face. He's basically a brawler. I mean, that's what he is. He's a melee warrior. And allowing him to have that slow kind of is the only way that Chen can either kite for himself, like to get out of the way, or if he's actually initiating. The tricky part here from a balance standpoint, and again, I don't try to profess that I'm sort of any game designer or a game balancer by any means, but the tricky thing about it in my imagination would be trying to make sure that the slow is not too powerful to where Chen can get away, but also making sure it is powerful enough to be some sort of a little escape there. Now, the reason why I say this is interesting is because if you look at the very top of the Chen changes, they are reducing his survivability, and they're also reducing his ability to get away from people. So, combined, whether or not this is going to be a good or a bad change for Chen, obviously it's remained to be seen because obviously the patch is not out yet. But I think it is very, very interesting that they're targeting the slow on top of targeting the survival and the overall base health of Chen as well as the health regen. So very, very interesting changes for Chen. And I realize I say interesting changes a whole lot, but it is true. Like I wish I could sit in on a Blizzard Heroes of the Storm balance meeting with the team and just figure out exactly why they do the tweaks they do. Maybe that would be an interesting interview opportunity one day. Anyway, how do you feel? Are you a Chen player out there? I'm not. But if you are a Crazy Uncle Chen player, let me know in the comments down below how you feel about these changes. ETC is going to be getting a little bit of help here for the damage side of things. Guitar Hero increased the heal amount from 30-35% of the auto attack damage dealt, which is very cool because I think that everyone takes Guitar Hero, and if you don't, then you're probably taking Power Slide, the Power Slide talent, I should say. Pinball Wizard, the increased bonus damage has been increased by a whole lot, by 50 additional percent, so now it deals literally double damage that you get from the Pinball Wizard talent, which is going to affect the Face Melter, and that is pretty darn awesome. And then the Echo Pedal, the decreased pulse damage has been decreased just a little bit, but that's in direct response to the changes that they're doing with a couple of the other things with the W ability. And then Mic Check, increased cooldown reduction of Face Melt from 5 to 6 seconds, which is also very cool indeed. So ETC players, rejoice, you're getting a little bit of help. Now, on to the biggest, probably surprising news, maybe not surprising, but it kind of depends on how you look at it. We're going to be getting a little bit of a revert on Zarya's buffs that were made live about a week and a half ago, coinciding with the Zarya release. So her basic attack damage, the base damage has been reduced again, going from 24 and back down to 21 now, as well as the base maximum health and the base health regeneration as well for Zarya. Now, a couple of things that are very interesting with the talent traits as well that they are the trait talent that they have reduced. They reduced the bonus energy upon quest repletion from 25 to 20, meaning that she can only have 20 maximum additional charges after completing that quest, which was not exactly all that. It's not all that difficult to complete, even though you saw me kind of complete it in the last episode of Solo Queue Silence that I did with Zarya, sort of late game, but there's better players out there than me, certainly, I'm curious as to whether or not this is actually going to affect people's talent changes, talent picks, rather, from level 1. I probably would say that it will have a little bit of an impact, but those 5 extra charges, I don't think are going to be that consequential to the picks for talents, because the other level 1 talents for Zarya, in my opinion, are not all that great, but they can still be quite good. The Demolitions Expert is one that I have tried out as well. The recharge rate reduction has been increased from a quarter of a second to 0.375 seconds, total of 3 seconds. Again, the level one changes here for Zarya are interesting to say the least, and there's that word again, interesting. I need to have a running tally of it anyway. I was very, very interested and curious to see Zarya changes up here on the patch notes. And the speed barrier movement speed has been increased from 25 to 35%, which I think is going to be a huge, huge buff to Zarya's survivability as well as her mobility as well. So, Blizzard says, we are reverting some of the previous Zarya buffs to bring her power level to where we want. We're also nerfing the benefits of maximum charge. Now that getting high energy isn't as difficult as it was previously. Again, see the previous patch notes for that. We've also buffed Demolition's Expert and Speed Barrier as they are substantially underperforming when compared to the other talents of their tiers. Again, talking about maximum charge versus Demolition's Expert, I still think that the pick is going to be maximum charge, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'll definitely have to do some testing on this. So either way, that is going to do it here. We have this patch coming up. This is not on the PTR. This is going to be on live in about a day and a half from now. Are you a Zarya player? Have you been loving her kit? Are you liking the new buffs? Are you super bummed out that she's going to get reverted? Are you an Azebo player? Really excited about the change and the damage buff to Ravenous Spirit, but also sort of lamenting at the nerf to Gargantuan? Let me know in the comments down below. I always read all the comments here. I'm very interested to hear what other players of other heroes and roles do think about these sort of changes, because it gives you kind of an insight on the community as a general and see the ever evolving shifting meta of the Heroes of the Storm metagame. So I'm going to wrap it up. Thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you for supporting here. 30,000 subs. That's awesome. I'm going to keep on going. If you keep watching, that is a deal and a half. And I do appreciate all the support. Again, find the links down below for all the official posts here. And of course, until next time, so long, everybody.